I am Frank Reilman. I am a member of parliament. I used to be senator in Belgium, and now I am chairman of the Committee on Foreign Affairs and European Affairs in the Flemish parliament, which is becoming the most important parliament of our country, because you know that, or you don't know that Belgium is a federal system with two major people, a French-speaking part, the south, and a Dutch-speaking part, the north. The north are the majority in the country, and we organize a federalist system, and in this federalist system, the Flemish Parliament and the Walloon Parliament for the French-speaking community are becoming the major issues. The federal parliament is declining its voice, in fact. Well, this compassion we talk about are in the books, in the three books of Abraham, indeed. But of course, the way things are evolving at the moment is that we see that the extremists, most of them are on the Islamic side, they are hurt much more than the tolerant Muslims. There are a lot of tolerant Muslims. I live in a community, Mechelen in Flanders, where there are 27% of people, most of them from Morocco, and of course they are Muslims. And okay, the problem is you don't hear the soft and the gentle and the moderate Muslims. You don't hear them, you don't see them on the streets, you don't see them, you only see these extremists. And it would be, of course, it would be nice for us to get together with Jews, with Israel, with the Christians in Europe, with the non-believers, and with the Muslims, if we could hear these moderate Muslims a little bit more than we do at the moment. So is unity, can we overcome that? Yes, we must. We must overcome that. It's very important that we overcome that. But at the moment, the extremists are getting their way. So my appeal to the Muslim world would say, get away from these extremists, get away from this extremism, show your voice, let your voice be heard by Christians, by Jews, by Israel, by Europe, and then we can come to unity. But get away, and the path, the path of extreme Islam is not the path to come together. Maybe we have to educate them, but the problem is with old books, the Bible, the Quran, the Talmud, and all these books, is that the people who want to explain them in a wrong way always scream a lot harder than those who want to explain them in the right way. And that is the problem for the Muslim world. The Muslim world must learn that this is not the Quran, that the Quran is what you say, peace, love, and all these things. But we don't hear that at the moment. We only hear these extremists. So let the peace, the word of the soft and the gentle Muslims be heard louder than those of the idiots. That is by appeal to the Muslim world. Of course, we don't live in the Muslim world. I live in Europe. In Europe, we see a lot of Muslim immigrants from Turkey. In Ghent, one of our cities, biggest cities in Flanders, is Ghent, where a lot of people from Turkey have a lot of friends in that community. And in my own town, from Morocco, a lot of Muslims. But a lot of these people, their voice isn't heard. And the voice you heard, what I said before, is that of the extremists. So get rid of that and try to give Islam a normal way of thinking, more modern than it is today. You know, these enclaves, these islands within our cities of Muslims, because they form a sort of islands. They don't mix with the people. The Turks are the best in that, I must say. But the people from Morocco, they don't really. Most of the Arabs, they don't really mingle with the people. They stay on their island. They stay in their own communities, in their own neighborhoods. They don't buy in our shops. They buy in their own shops. This is not a good thing for the future, because if you stay on your island, then unity will never come. Yeah, well, if there is one Islamic country that can become leader of this Muslim world, it is Turkey. Turkey has been always a secular state. I think the way Kemal Atatürk looked at Turkey is much more the way the West thinks a nation should be built. So in a way, Turkey can become the leader of the Muslim world and can become this unifying factor and this moderating factor of the Islamic world. But of course, that's to Turkey to decide. I'm not Turkish. I cannot do that for you. Yeah, okay, but unity under the leadership of Turkey can maybe interesting in the region. I don't say in the Muslim world, Turkey can be an example. It's always interesting that people from, even if they are from a different belief or from a different way of looking at politics, talk together. So if we talk then we people who talk, they won't make war. That's my final message. Who talks doesn't make war. It's what you see at the moment in Israel. You see that a lot of Arab people live there. They breed their children there. They have work. They have homes. In fact, they are better treated than in some of their own countries in Saudi Arabia, Yemen, and wherever. They are better off living. The Arab people are better off living in Israel than living in their so-called own states. So there is a lot of work for you, I think.